go and the weeks flew by until he moved on the shore, leaving his caravan behind. It was parked out on the southeast ridge, and as the company crossed the bridge, with the first rain fell on the bone dry riverbed, it shone just so upon the edge. Away, away, we're sad to say. Dog boy, Atlas, Hoffman, the geeks, the hired hands, there was not one among them who did not cast an eye behind in the hope that the Carny would return to his own kind. All skin and bone, a bow-backed nag that he named Sorrow. Now it's buried in an unmarked grave where the old nag was laid in the then parched meadow. And it was the dwarves who were given the task of digging the ditch and laying the nag's carcass in the ground, with Boss Bellini waving his smoking pistol round, saying,
"The nag is dead, mate. We can't afford to carry dead weight."
The whole company standing around, not making a sound. And to the dwarves perched on the enclosure gate, the boss says,
"Bury that lump of crow, mate."
Down and the rain it hammered down.
Who fell off their trolley?